the circle not only covering the part of China, should also cover what India controlled and also Bhutan controlled. But to my knowledge, that India already building the strongholds, even tunnels, even in the areas around the Jimumaja snow crested peak. So that is unfair if comparing to China, Chinese side. We haven't even built a road connected to the ridge of the mountain.
Even when did the Indian buildup happen?
That is, it happened in 1980s.
From 1980s on?
Even before 1980s, because in the 1980s, Chinese, geographer, which want to know the ground realities, they found that there are already 40 strongholds built around the snow-crested mountain. That is in 1980, June.
Okay, Mr. Aneja, why did you have to build, and why can't China build from the Chinese side?
No, the point is that, you know, we have these broad formulations. Now, to come to specifics, we have the technology now to do it, and we move in that direction and sort it out.
Okay.
Rather than saying that this is ours and this is yours, this is taking a position
According to Mr. Aneja,
into specifics.
It seems originally the place has never been decided as to who it belongs to.
No, well, I don't think so, because clearly the Bhutanese herdsmen actually pay tax to China as early as the 1950s. And the Xizang,
do you have documents to convey that?
Yes, because these kind of received as a kind of original document are still kept in the Tibet Museum, which could be seen by everybody.
And so, if they pay the taxes, what does that mean?
That means we have sovereignty over it. No. Otherwise, how could they pay taxes to us?
No, they